and we are going to discuss basically today about the gene regulation in prokaryotes. Hello everyone, my name is Khushmeet Kaur and I am taking your Botany Optional. Today we are going to discuss one PYQ, and the PYQ is that given account of approval model for regulation of gene. This is a PYQ from the year 2021 and we are going to discuss basically today about the gene regulation in prokaryotes. Okay, so let's start. So we are going to discuss about gene regulation in prokaryotes. For this, first we have to understand what do you understand by gene regulation. When I say gene regulation, it means regulation of gene expression. Okay, so gene regulation simply means regulation of gene expression. So what is gene expression now? Let's understand. Like for example, this is my DNA, right? My DNA has several number of genes in it. Then, if you are aware of the central dogma, in the central dogma, the DNA first replicates itself, then it transcribes to form mRNA and then finally to the protein. So here also, the DNA is first going to replicate and after that, it is going to transcribe to form mRNA through the process of transcription. And finally, it is going to form proteins by the process of translation. And this was replication. Yes. So what I was saying is, this particular DNA has several genes. And these genes are transcribed into mRNA and then finally into protein. When can we actually say that this gene has been expressed? We can say that this particular gene in the DNA has been expressed when it is actually at the protein level. So whenever proteins are made from the DNA, we can say that the genes are finally expressed. Okay, so here we are talking about the regulation of gene expression. That means the protein level, at the protein level we are talking, okay? So genes are expressed when they are at their protein level. This much is understood, right? So we are going to regulate these genes. Now, why to regulate genes? What is the regulation of genes? Let us understand by understanding two types of genes. Okay, I can bifurcate genes in two categories. The first one is known as housekeeping genes. And the second one is known as luxury genes. Okay. So basically, housekeeping genes are those genes which are required by the cell all the time. Like for example, you have some best friend, okay? You require your best friend all the time, but you also have other friends that are not very close to you. You will not go to those friends for every other chaos in your life, but you will go to your best friend. Similarly, these genes are continuously being produced in the cell. They don't need any kind of regulation. Like for example, if I say that the genes which are required for protein synthesis, okay, so no matter what type of protein is being made, but these genes will be required, okay? So housekeeping genes are the genes which are being continuously synthesized or expressed in the cell, okay? Then what are luxury genes? Luxury genes are the ones which are only produced when there is a need. Like for example, imagine a plant is facing a stress condition. Maybe it can be some kind of abiotic stress like flood or drought, okay? So when the plant will be facing such kind of conditions, what it will do? It will activate some genes which will help the plant to overcome that abiotic situation. Like for example, a plant is there and it is facing drought conditions. So what will happen? As a defense mechanism, it will activate some kind of genes which will help the plant to overcome that particular stress, okay? Now, when, for example, the drought is over, there is no need for the plant to keep that genes on. Okay. Basically, the plant need not produce these genes all the time in the cell. They can be only produced when there is a need for the plant. Why? Because if I will keep those genes, if I will keep producing those genes, like throughout the cycle, throughout the time, what will happen? A lot of energy will be consumed. And plant does not want to waste this much energy. Okay. I am saying plant, but here I am talking about prokaryotic. So I'm just giving you an example. Okay. So luxury genes are what? Luxury genes are the ones which are produced only when there is a need. So such kind of genes need a regulation. Regulation that whether they should be produced or not, or regulation how much should they be produced, what is the quantity, or whether they should be produced or not. So these are the two factors. Okay. So regulation of such genes will be required. But these type of genes does not require any regulation. Why? Because they are continuously being needed in the cell. But these are needed at a specific time or a specific condition. Okay. So we need a regulation for these type of genes. Now let us understand their regulation. Whenever we try to understand the regulation of genes, it is better to study through the prokaryotic model. Because in prokaryotes, the complexity is very, very less. The organisms are simple. So understanding the gene regulation through prokaryotes will help you to understand actually what is gene regulation. So right now, we are going to understand gene regulation in prokaryotes. When I say prokaryotes, I am talking about E. coli. Okay, and this was given by Jacob and Monard. And they gave, for understanding this particular concept, they gave us what? Operon model. Now, what is this operon model? Let's understand through the help of this diagram. Okay, let's make here okay, this is O, P, A, B, C, and let it be R and promoter. Okay, we will first understand this half, then we will move towards this half. Okay, so the main components of an operon system are promoter, operator, and these are structural genes. So there are basically three components. What are the three components? Promoter, operator, and the third one is structural genes. Let's understand their role one by one. When I talk about promoter, as you have studied replication and transcription already, promoter needs what? Promoter is the point where the transcription is going to start. Okay, and how it will start? It will start only when RNA polymerase is going to bind here. So this is the site for binding of RNA polymerase. Okay, let me make it a little thicker. This is the site for binding of RNA polymerase. If this is my RNA polymerase, this is RNA polymerase. So promoter is the site where my RNA polymerase is going to bind. Then what is operator? Operator is like a on-off switch. It is like a on-off switch. That means if it is on, then the RNA polymerase can come and bind to the promoter. But if the operator decides to be off, then the RNA polymerase cannot bind to the promoter. And if it will not bind to the promoter, there will be no transcription of genes and no translation of genes. Okay? Because the transcription will only start when this RNA polymerase binds to the promoter. Okay. And whether it will bind or not, who will decide? Operator is going to decide. Now, how this operator is going to be on or off, that is what we are going to discuss. Before that, let's see what are these. I have just taken three variables and these are known as structural genes. Okay. These are known as structural genes. These are the genes which will actually get transcribed in this operon model and will form protein. Okay, these are the genes which will actually get transcribed and form mRNA. And then finally, from the mRNA, they are going to form protein. ठीक है, बट दे विल ओनली फॉर्म प्रोटीन और दे विल ओनली फॉर्म mRNA व्हेन दिस RNA पॉलीमरेज इज अटैच्ड टू द प्रमोटर. ओके, नाउ अपस्ट्रीम टू दिस वी हैव टू थिंग्स. आई हैव रिटन टू थिंग्स हियर. दिस R स्टैंड्स फॉर रिप्रेसर. What is repressor? Repressor is a molecule that will, if this repressor binds to the operator, okay, if this repressor binds to the operator, then the operator will be turned off. Okay, when repressor is bound to the operator, then it is going to be off. And if repressor fails to bind to the operator, then the operator will be on. And do you know what is the effect of on, what is the on-off effect of the operator on the promoter? You know that now, right? So this repressor is actually also known as regulator gene. ठीक है, if it will bind to the operator, then the model will be off. You can write like this. If this regulator gene will bind to the operator, then it will be off. And if it is unable to bind to the operator, then the model will be on. ठीक है, and this regulator gene also has a promoter. Like these genes have a promoter here. Similarly, this repressor gene also have a promoter here. Okay, as you can see here, several genes are regulated by a single promoter. So, such type of model is known as polycistronic model. Okay, in prokaryotes, we generally see polycistronic model. What is polycistronic? Where many genes are regulated by a single promoter. This is not the case in the case of eukaryotes. In eukaryotes, single gene, single promoter. But here, in the case of prokaryotes, multiple genes are regulated by a single promoter. Okay? Now, let's get deep into it by understanding this operon model through an example. And that example is lac operon. Okay? So, let's start. What is this lac operon? Lac stands for a disaccharide sugar known as lactose. What is disaccharide? That means this particular sugar is made up of two sugars. If I break down this lactose, I am going to get glucose plus galactose. Okay, this reaction in which the lactose is broken down into glucose and galactose is a catabolic reaction. This is a catabolic reaction. Okay, if I draw the model here for you, okay, this is promoter, this is lacI, this is again promoter, operator, Z, Y and A. Let's understand this. Okay, this is promoter, I have already told you. This is operator. ठीक है, दिस ऑपरेटर एक्चुअली हैज अ साइट फॉर रिप्रेसर प्रोटीन. ऑलवेज रिमेंबर, दिस ऑपरेटर हैज अ साइट फॉर योर रिप्रेसर प्रोटीन. देन देयर आर थ्री स्ट्रक्चरल जीन्स, जेड, वाई एंड ए. जेड कोड्स फॉर एन एंजाइम बीटा गैलेक्टोसाइडेज. वाई कोड्स फॉर परमीएस एंड ए कोड्स फॉर ट्रांस एसिटेलेज. What are the roles of these enzymes? If I talk about this first enzyme, that is beta-galactosidase, the breakdown of lactose into glucose and galactose is regulated by beta-galactosidase. There is one another role which I will tell you later. The second one is permease. Permease allows the entry of lactose into the cell. And transacetylase helps in the transfer of the acetyl group in the glucose. Okay, so these are the rules, roles of the lac operon structural genes. This is what this is. This is my repressor gene. This is my repressor gene. Okay? So the first condition that we are going to talk about, where there is no lactose present in the cell, what will happen in the cell then? Okay, let's understand. Okay. Let's make a cell. Let's make a cell and operon also. This is my operon model. A, Y, Z, operator, this is promoter, this is lacI gene, which is a repressor molecule, and this is the promoter of the lacI gene. Now, what will happen? First, let's write when lactose is absent. In the absence of lactose, okay, in the understanding the gene regulation, you also have to use your common sense. Okay, if there is no lactose, what it is actually going to break down? Okay, there is nothing to break. Okay, so this model will be on or off. Think about it. Now what will happen? This LACI gene is going to produce mRNA. Then it is going to form a protein. Okay, then this repressor protein is going here and it is going to attach at the operator site. This is my repressor molecule, repressor protein. This repressor molecule, because there is no one to stop this repressor molecule. So it will go and it will bind to the operator site. I told you, once the repressor molecule is bound to the operator site, it will turn itself off. It will turn off. That means what? That means the RNA polymerase will come here. Okay. Yeah. The RNA polymerase will come here, but it will not be able to bind to the promoter. And we know for a matter of fact, if the RNA polymerase is unable to bind to the promoter, what will happen? There will be no transcription and hence there will be no translation. So this all over model is turned off. Understood what has happened? There is nothing to stop this repressor. So this repressor protein is formed. This repressor protein has a site here and it will go and bind to the operator site. Once the operator is bind with the repressor, promoter, in the promoter side, the RNA polymerase will not be able to bind. And these genes are not transcribed or translated. So no protein will be formed. There is no breakdown of lactose. Okay, now let us consider the position where the lactose has entered the cell. So let's start with the entry of lactose into the cell. Okay, so this is my cell. Of course, it has a membrane. So here we have a protein. This is permease. Okay, this is permease. And through this permease, I told you permease regulates the entry of lactose into the cell. So the permease will regulate the entry of lactose into the cell. So lactose has come inside the cell. Okay. Now this lactose will be converted into its form, that is allolactose. Okay. Let me draw the molecules of allolactose. Okay. This is allolactose. Now what will happen? See, very interesting. Achha, I told you there are two roles of beta-galactosidase. First, I told you that beta-galactosidase helps in the breakdown of lactose into glucose and galactose. And the second role is that lactose sugar is broken, is converted into allolactose using beta-galactosidase. Galactosidase. Okay, let's draw the model here. This is my model. Okay, this is promoter, this is LACI gene, this is promoter, this is operator, has having a site for the LACI gene, like LACI gene protein rather, I would say. This is Z, Y and A. Okay, now what will happen? This LACI gene, again, it is going to produce what? It is going to produce mRNA. Again, it is going to produce the repressor protein. This is the repressor protein. Now, what will happen? Very important step. Because the lactose is present in the cell, this allolactose molecule, what will happen? Some of it will come here and bind to the repressor protein. Allolactose molecule will come and it will bind to the repressor protein. Once it will bind to the repressor protein, it will change the configuration of the repressor protein. That means what will happen? Here, the configuration of the repressor protein will be changed. Configurational change. Now, even if this repressor protein tries, it cannot bind to the operator. Why? Because the configuration has been changed. There was a particular site at the operator by which this repressor protein binds, but once the allolactose is bound to this particular repressor proteins, it changed its configuration. Now this protein is no longer eligible of binding to the operator. So hence, there is no binding of operator, no binding of repressor protein at the operator site. What will happen? Now very, very happily, what will happen? Here, the RNA polymerase will come and it will able to bind to the promoter. Okay, RNA polymerase will come. Okay, RNA polymerase will come. Little bit zyada ho gaya ye, ruko. And it will bind to the promoter. Once it binds to the promoter, what will happen? The transcription of these genes will start. They will form their respective mRNA and then finally they will form their respective proteins. So we can say the model will be turned on when lactose is present. So what is the difference? You here see, when the lactose was absent, there was nothing to repress this repressor. Okay, nothing to stop this repressor. So this repressor molecule went to the operator and bound to the operator, and hence there was no transcription and translation because it did not let the RNA polymerase to bind on the promoter side. And without the binding, the transcription and translation cannot start. But in the presence of lactose sugar, what happens? The permease let the lactose sugar inside the cell, and then the lactose sugar was converted into allolactose. This allolactose molecule act as a co-repressor molecule and it bound to the repressor. Once it bound to the repressor, it changed its configuration. Now, this will no longer bind to the operator. Now, very happily, RNA polymerase will come and bind to the promoter and the transcription and translation will occur. Okay? It is very simple. If I want to sum up here, it is very simple that when lactose is present, okay, if the lactose is present, obviously, if it is present, then it will be broken down to the glucose and galactose because the cell needs glucose. So, what happened? If the lactose is present, the model will be on. Okay, but if the lactose is absent, that means there is nothing to break down. So, it will be off. Okay, just like we have the repressor as a negative regulator. Repressor here, if I talk about repressor molecule, if I talk about the repressor molecule, it acts as a negative regulator. That means, negative regulator ka matlab kya ho gaya? When the repressor molecule is present, it is just joining to the operator and acts as a negative regulator of the Oberon model of lacoperone. Right? There is also a positive regulator. And that is CAMP. Okay. So what will happen? Suppose if the glucose level is low in the cell. What will happen? Glucose level is low. So obviously cell wants to break down lactose so that they can get glucose, right? So what will happen here? The CAMP level increases. Okay. And it binds to the CAP. That is CAMP protein binding site. Okay, it binds to there, and there near the promoter, it induces the model, the operon model, and the model is hence turned on. What I am trying to say is, when the glucose level are low, the CAMP level are high. Okay, and when the CAMP level is high, then it binds to the site near to the promoter where it induces the model. It induces the transcription and translation. Okay, and on the other side, when the glucose is present in the cell. Of course, if the glucose is present, why will cell want to use energy and break down lactose? So what will happen when the glucose is present? Then the CAMP level is less in the cell. Okay? The level are so less that they are not able to bind to the site near the promoter. Okay, no binding. And hence, there is no induction of the model. Okay, so how can you relate? Glucose less, that means lactose sugar, it needs to be broken down. So CAMP level high, CAMP induces the model. Okay, glucose more, CAMP less, that means no binding and no induction of the model. You can sum up like this. Lactose present, the model is on. Lactose absent, the model is off. Okay, if glucose present, the model will be off. Glucose present hai na, so why it will break down? And if the glucose is absent, that means the model will be on. So this is the both regulation of the Oberon model. Okay, I hope the model is clear to you. Thank you so much.